Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Good evening. Today in our lecture, we will know what is the Norton Theorem, how we can calculate the Norton equilibrium. Let's go deeply to the important information to know how we can calculate the Norton resistance, how we can calculate the current of Norton, and all the other important information. At first, it's huge similarity between Norton Theorem and Thevenin Theorem. Actually, the resistance will be the same, and we will see all of that at the next page. Here we can use it in any circuit, has many elements, I mean resistance, different value of resistance, and many sources, current sources or voltage sources, to simplify this circuit to just one current source with parallel resistance. Here I repeat, with parallel resistance, not with series resistance, because it's the difference. One of these difference is here Norton theorem dealing with parallel resistance, Thevenin theorem dealing with series resistance. This image is great, can illustrate to us what we will do. What the important steps we must follow it to can calculate the Norton resistance or the Norton current and the other. Here we have circuit with many sources and different value of resistance. Here we have the device, the important device or the load. We want the wanted from us to calculate, for example, the current through from this device, because that here we say A and B, or we selected these two important points, A and D. And we after that, we will try to calculate the Norton resistance to can calculate the current, Norton current by using Ohm law. At first, we must follow these important steps. At first, we will ignore the element who wanted to calculate the current or voltage to it. After that, calculate select A, B letters position. At first, we will ignore this device to be like open circuits. And here we will select to A position, B position to be like that. Calculate the Norton resistance. We will do the same thing with Thevenin resistance. Any independent or any current source will be open source. Any voltage source will be short circuit. Here will be open circuit. Any voltage source will be short circuit to be like that to can calculate the Norton resistance. At last, put short circuits between A and B like that and calculate IN, Norton current. Draw the circuit with parallel resistance with Norton resistance parallel. We will connect this resistance parallel with the current source. And with putting the element to ignore it at first, I mean RL. Note when the direction from A to B, the current direction with at reverse direction. Here, this note is important. We will use it at the last of the solving example. Here, I was talking about this arrow. It's from this side, from A to B, that's mean. Actually, like we know, the current direction from the source will be from earth to up, like that. The current will go through like that. And from here to the resistance, to come back to this node like Kirchhoff current law. Here it's the first solving example. Find the equivalent of Norton at the circuit below between A and B at RL. After that, calculate the IL at the RL, the current through from L resistance. Here we have three amounts of resistance. We have one independent voltage source, one independent current source. At first, RL, where is RL? RL here equal 2 ohm, because that will put A, B, and say it's open circuit. That means no current will flow from it. After that, we will dealing with the current, independent current source like open circuit, voltage source like volt circuit, and try to calculate Norton resistance. Here we have two parallel resistance, because that will say 4.4 divided on 8 to be 2 ohm. Norton resistance. Now let's calculate Norton current by using superposition. Here we will start from effect of 8 ampere. That means by depending on this effect and ignore the voltage source to be like a short circuit, like that. The current will come from here to be to this side, and we put it line, we connected A and B to be to like short circuit. The current, that mean, will flow from B to A and will not flow from this resistance, because the current, it's a smart element, always select the easier way, because that will flow from B to A. To come back to here again. Here, IN dash, we can say Norton current one or dash, but I selected dash, I think it's easier to me, equal IS. Here, because the current will flow from the easier way, and no current will flow from this resistance, the same situation with this resistance, because that IS will equal 8 ampere. Now let's focus on effect of the independent voltage source, 16 volt, and here will be like open circuit. And this wire will still connected between A and B. But here we will say what will happen. The current will come from this side. No current will flow from here and come back by using this wire to the source. No current will flow from here. That means here we just have one current. IN double dash equal IS2. Can say here IS2 equal. Actually, we can use Ohm's law, because we have the value of the voltage. That means 16 volt divided on 4 ohm. IS2 equal 4 ampere. Here, IS1 equal 8 ampere. Norton current equal IN dash plus IN double dash. But here, like we know, the current came from here to come back, and here the current come from up to down. That's mean here we have different arrow. Because that I put it minus between them to be the last value be positive, positively equal 4 ampere. Now we have the Norton resistance, we have the current resistance. Let's draw our circuit to be like that. Norton resistance will be parallel with Norton current, and the load will be between A and B. Here, the current through from this resistance will be divided onto to be 2 ampere, because here the current will come from here, go through from Norton resistance, and the other part, other value from Norton current will through from RL to be 2 ampere. Find the Norton equivalent circuit on V equal 10 volts. That's mean here. That's mean A and B will be here, and this wire will be like open circuit. And calculate I, this current through from this device. But here the situation, we can note this different here, because here we must calculate the current through from voltage source, not through from resistance. Because that, like I said before, at first let's calculate Norton current. Here open circuit, here short circuit, because we have a voltage source. Actually we have two voltage sources. First one wanted from us calculate the current through from it. That's mean we were dealing with just one voltage source, and we say it's open circuit. Let's calculate Norton resistance will be, we have two parallel resistance. That's mean 25 plus 30.60 divided on 90 ampere to be the last result equal 45 ohm. That's great. Now let's calculate the Norton current. By using superposition to calculate Norton current, here, just we put it a piece of wire between A and B to can make the current through from A to B. Here we have just we have one independent voltage source. The current will come from here and come back from here. Here we have two parallel resistance, because that we can calculate it to be 13.63 ohm, and we can put it here. And the other resistance is 60 ohm. We have VS equal 15 volt. Now we can say, equal VS 15 ohm dot 13.63 divided on 13.63 plus 60 ohm to be the result equal 2.77 volt. Now, VN equal VA, because here we can connect this line with the earth. That's mean VB equals zero. Like we know, V, like I said before, V Thevenin voltage was equal A, VAB, that's mean VA minus VB, VB equals zero. That's mean equal VA. Here we use the same way. Here I calculated, let's say VA, and at the same time equal Norton voltage. Because that I put it N to equal 2.77 volts. Now let's calculate the current IA. It's be IN plus. IN plus, that's mean by using Ohm law, VN divided on, or we can ignore this plus, this dash. That's up on you. Here equal Norton voltage divided on the resistance, 25 ohm. Here to be the result equal 0.0 ampere, not milliampere, or 0.11 ampere. Here, all of that by use the calculate VA. Here, let's say effect of the independent voltage source equal 15 volt. What will happen? Here we have the same situation. Here we have two parallel resistance with one independent voltage. Wanted from us calculate the current through from this device, independent voltage source, or from this, the same amount, 10 volt, and calculate here, I'm sorry. We must calculate the current through from this device. Here, we can calculate the Norton resistance again, or we can say directly it's equal 45 ohm. Now, IS equal VS divided on RN. Directly, we have a VS equal 10 volt divided on RN equal 0.222 ampere. Because the direction it's are the same, we put it here minus here, the current from this side, from A, from B to A, here, from A to B, that's mean different arrow, that's mean minus. We must put minus between them. And the last value will be positively equal O dot 112 ampere from B to A, because here it's bigger than from B to A, because that will, it will take the same direction with the bigger amount. From B to A, the direction, the current will flow from here. From B to A, what does mean? That's mean here, the current direction will be from this side and through from the device. That's mean can calculate the direction of current, can image the current direction from this trick. From B to A, that's mean the current will come back from here to come back to B point and keep going. Because that I draw arrow from up to down. From Ohm's law, V equal IR equal 5.04 voltage. Here it's the voltage source. We have two kind of independent voltage source. We can calculate all of them to can know the total voltage of the circuit. After that, by using Ohm law with total resistance will be the current at 10 voltage will be dot 334 ampere. Let's take a look on this example again. We have two parts of the solution. We dependent on, at first we calculate the Norton resistance. After that, we take the effect of the 15 volts here and come back to calculate the effect of the another source, like we're seeing here. This effect of 15 volts. Yes, that's right. And we calculate all of these arrows. Here, let's take another example. This image of this circuit, we have known elements of the dependent voltage equal 192. And calculate güç değerine bulunuz, calculate the power at this voltage. Here. Wanted from us calculate the power at this independent voltage source. Okay, because that we will say A and B here and ignore this device. Calculate the Norton resistance. After that, put our piece of wire between A and B and keep going. Here, IS equal 9 ampere, VS equal IS dot R ohms law. IS equal 10 ampere. Let's calculate VS by using ohm law will equal 36 volts because with this resistance with 4 ohm. To be VS equal 36 volts. Here, we can calculate all of them to be 12 ohm with 2 ampere. Here, we will try specifically, we will try to simplify the circuit like we're seeing here to can calculate the current at the 192 volts at this independent voltage source. After that, we will calculate, we will try to convert this independent voltage source to current source by Ohm's law here equal 36 volts divided on 12 ohms because we calculate all of them. It was equal 8 plus 4 to be 12 ohms. The last result of this source will be equal 3 ohm. Now here we have two independent current source. That means we can calculate all of them to kind of simplify this side more to be with different arrow. That means minus will be 1 ampere here. That means here we simplified all of these part to be here just 1 ampere with 11 ohms. Yes, 11 ohms here, 12 ohms, and here 24 ohms with the same devices. Now here we have voltage, independent voltage source. To can simplify these two sources, we must convert this current to voltage source by its own law. Here equal I dot resistance to be 12 volt VN. That means here we can now, after this result, we can calculate all of them. We will calculate all of these two results of resistance to be 24 ohms with a voltage source to be like that. Series resistance, we can calculate all of them to be 48 with the same value of the voltage source, like that. Now, by using Ohm law, we can calculate, we can convert this voltage to current to be 12 volt divided on 48 ohm to be 0.25 ampere. Now we have two current sources by after this result. Now let's calculate all of them to be 2 ampere. That's mean here we have 2 ampere and the loss resistance here 48 with only the device we want to calculate the power on it. Or we can just put A and B and between all of them piece of wire. Now let's calculate the power. That means we need the current through from this device here. P equal IV, that's mean 2 ampere dot the voltage we have the result to can calculate it. That's mean just we wanted to calculate Norton current to can calculate the power at this source. The last one is here. It's easier from the last one. Here, the load, just I said A and B. And we have 3 different values of resistance with dependent current source, voltage source. Calculate the Thevenin equivalent at the circuit above. Here, just we will say, at first, let's calculate the Thevenin resistance. Like I said before, between the load A and B, and will be like open circuit, current source, open circuit, voltage source, short circuit, and calculate Thevenin volt resistance to be equal 10 ohms. Now, V Thevenin voltage equal VAB. Here, by put that piece of wire to connect with the earth, will be here 0, VA. We can say here VA, and VA will equal the Thevenin voltage. And we will say Thevenin voltage minus 12 volt divided on 3 ohm plus Thevenin voltage divided on 6 ohm minus 1 ampere equals 0 by using Kirchhoff current law. The total current will equal 0. To simplify this equation and calculate Thevenin voltage equal 10 volt. Here, after that, let's draw our circuit. The Thevenin resistance will connected by use series method, series way to with the Thevenin voltage like that. Now to calculate the power, we must know the current resistance, the current value by using Ohm law. I equal Thevenin voltage divided on Thevenin resistance will be 1 ampere. That's mean by using the same Thevenin voltage, P equal 10 volt, because 10 volt dot 1 ampere. Oha, we have another question. Yes, last 2 questions here. Here, by use the same way, calculate the Thevenin equivalent and calculate the the current at RL by using Norton equation. Here, the situation is different and will be more complicated because we will use Thevenin and Norton equation or theorem at the same time. We have 3 different amounts of resistance. Here, independent current, dependent voltage, will be open circuit, short circuit, open circuit, like that. Calculate the Thevenin resistance, and it's equal, we can say that by using the same way to calculate Norton resistance, will be like that, 2 parallel resistance, and with 1 series resistance. Now let's try to calculate VTH here. Let's say equal 0 VA here by using current Kirchhoff current law. The I total equals 0 here. VA minus 100 voltage divided on 8 ohm. VA minus 7 ampere plus VA divided on 3 ohm plus 7 ohm minus VA divided on 3 ohm. We have two series resistance, 3 ohm plus 3 ohm to be 6 ohm. And here VC up to simplify all of this equation will equal 66.85 volt. Now this VC that's mean here, this VC. Now we know we need to calculate VA here, this point C. VC equals 66, approximately 66, 0.85 volts. By using this value, we can calculate VA by saying VA or V Thevenin voltage equal VC dot the resistance at first behavior of us dot R3 divided on R3 plus R2 to be V Thevenin equal 33.42 volts. Now we can plot our circuit like that. Norton plot with here, it's Thevenin resistance connected seriously with the Thevenin volt, and the source, the device will be between A and B. Now let's calculate the, we can say load upon you. Here, let's calculate R, I at this device by using Ohm law to be I equal V Thevenin voltage divided on R Thevenin resistance plus RL. Here, wait a second, no. Here we calculate the current at Thevenin source, Thevenin voltage source, because that we will say Thevenin voltage divided on, we can say Thevenin resistance. Thevenin resistance, like we calculated at first, equal 2.35. Let's take a look, 2.35, that's right. After that, we calculate the, we can say Thevenin current or the current through from this resistance by using Ohm's law. Now let's calculate the IL through from this resistance, but by using by make the resistance be parallel with the Norton current source, like this figure here. IL will equal IN dot RN divided on RN plus RL. Let me say that again. We calculate the IN at first from the Thevenin voltage. And after that, by using this value, we can calculate IL by say IL equal IN dot this resistance RN divided on RN plus RL. At first will be the resistance behind of me, and after that will be the resistance who be near from me or beside me. But at first I will say dot the resistance in front of me like that, RN, after that divided on RN plus the resistance beside me to be equal 4 ampere, IL. We use this track. At first we calculated the Norton current or the current by benefit from Thevenin voltage. After that, by using this result, we could to calculate IL. That's mean here at the solution, we used all of the Thevenin theorem and Norton theorem. It's important. That's it. Our lecture is done. Thank you for listening, your patience. Have a good day.